Venha, mamá, chihuahua.
Hey guys, it's Camera Review for the remake of The Lion King. And of course, I'm pretty sure we all know the plot, but if you somehow don't, essentially what this film's about is we center on the character of Simba. He is the son of Mufasa, who is the king of Pride Rock at the time and things like that, but you also have Mufasa's brother Scar, who was next in line to become king, and Simba is now ostensibly the person that is compromising that position, and You know, Scar is trying to do what he can to overthrow them and things like that, and basically the film is Simba trying to, you know, become king, but also try to, you know, make sure that Scar doesn't get in the way, and that's really all I'm gonna say. And when it comes to this remake, I'm not gonna lie, out of all the Disney live action, even though this isn't technically a live action film really at all, but of all the Disney remakes we were getting, this was the one I came back to where I said, okay, maybe this can work. We have Jon Favreau at the helm, we know the work he did in The Jungle Book, we have a really talented cast of actors here who I think really can pull this off. Is this a film we need? No, but you know, I went back to like Beauty and the Beast and how that turned out, so I really thought this could be something great. The photorealism and things like that, it really seemed like they were gonna bring something different and something fresh to this film. But even though I was very optimistic about it, the more trailers and things like that I started to see of this remake, the more tired of it I really started to become. I started to question, you know, why is this even necessary and things like that. But I was holding out hope that the film was going to surprise me, that the film would give me something different, that the film would feel fresh and things like that. And I'm sorry to say that my worries were very much warranted, because I'm sorry to say that I really did not like this one at all. The Lion King, I hate to say, is a soulless shot-for-shot remake that really has no reason to exist at all, and honestly is probably one of the weakest of the remakes that we've gotten, but we're just gonna enter right now, starting off with the cast. And like I said, going into this film, I think that's going to be one of the biggest draws for sure. And honestly, it mostly doesn't deliver all that much. A lot of the cast here just really isn't that great. Let's talk about Donald Glover. Donald Glover is someone that I respect the hell out of. I think he's one of the hardest working men out there. You know, he's one of the best talents for sure. And he was one of those things that made me think this is going to be something great. And I think that's something we all collectively agreed with, is that Donald Glover was going to be one of the best things about this movie. Similar to how we didn't think Will Smith, you know, how we thought Will Smith was going to be the worst thing about Aladdin, I think a lot of us thought Donald Glover might be the best thing about this new Lion King, and I'm sorry to say, that's not the case. I mean, look, he's not bad here, but this is Donald Glover, one of the best talents working today, and the fact that he isn't giving 100% into this role is shocking. He is ridiculously flat here. There are so many line readings that just do not really seem like he was into it at all. He does not convey that emotion that Simba needs. He doesn't have that sense of heroism that he's supposed to have either. It just didn't really work here, and I really don't know what happened. Like I said, Glover's such a talented and multi-layered actor. I mean, this was the guy who was the best thing about Solo: A Star Wars Story. I mean, we know the kind of talent he has, and the fact that he didn't bring something amazing to this is legitimately shocking to me. I really don't know how this turned out the way it did, but I really did not think he was that great here. However, there are two performances that I very much can praise here, and that is of Billy Eichner and Seth Rogen. Now, when we first heard these two were casted, I think we all pretty much thought that is perfect, and it very much is. Now look, do they top what Nathan Lane and Ernie Sabella did? No, those are iconic characters, and those two voice actors did some phenomenal work for sure. You can't really recapture that, but I feel like Eichner and Rogen, they did what they could to bring something of their own to the role. And they do an excellent job of that, particularly Rogan. I mean, he's just so well casted here as Pumbaa. You can tell he's having the time of his life here, and the chemistry between those two, they just bounce off of each other so well, and I really loved what they ended up doing here for sure. Eichner, you know, is just as sort of self-involved and just as, you know, quick as you know, just as quippy as Timon was, while Pumbaa is just as lazy and just as you know, dramatic and things like that as Pumbaa's supposed to be. And I think that's something that they did very well here. I thought they did some really great work here. They had some of the best lines in the movie for sure, and they're easily, I think, the best thing about this entire film, without a doubt. The rest of the cast here, unfortunately, is not really all that great. Chiwetel Ejiofor, I was very worried about, and I will say he's good, but he's not in the same movie. I mean, I don't know what he is really doing. The way he's acting here, it felt like he thought he was in some, like, Shakespearean drama. And again, he's good, he doesn't fit this role. Like, as Scar, it doesn't really work. It's kind of hard to say. Like, he's giving his all for sure, but it doesn't feel like he's in the same movie. He's just, he takes the role extremely seriously. And Jeremy Irons, he brought a certain charisma that Ejiofor just can't live up to, and it really just not work as well as you'd want it to. Beyonce, you know, she's Nala here, and she does the best that she can, but I've said it before, I really don't think she's that strong an actress, and this film does not prove to me otherwise. I really did not think she was that great here. John Oliver's a comedian I very much respect, but his Zazu, I just didn't really think worked all that well. This Zazu is far more wimpy and just kind of dumb, and I just wasn't really that big of a fan of him. I just didn't really think he did that great of a job. Alfred Woodard, for what she has, is okay. The three hyenas have almost nothing to do, but I guess they were fine. Also, J.D. McCrary and Sharati Wright Joseph, I pretty much feel the same way about both of them. They were fine for what they had. I did think there were some points where J.D. McCrary's line readings wasn't really the best, but they did the best with what they could, I suppose. I mean, they didn't really do anything that great, but they were fine for what they had. Easily, though, the most disappointing, I have to say, is that of James Earl Jones as Mufasa, who, again, I've said this before, I was very much against the idea of them, you know, just having him do the same thing again. It just felt really lazy to me. But even though I did feel the way, I expected for him to give a really great performance because he's so iconic in that role and he is irreplaceable, but here he's just so dull. And similar to Glover, his line ring is shockingly flat. It seems like they've taken everything that's powerful and all of that emotion he poured into role out of Mufasa and just made him a lot more dull. And I couldn't tell if it was just James Earl Jones was bored or if they directed him that way. I really don't know what happened here, but I really did not think he was that great. And that was very shocking to me. I mean, this is James Earl Jones, the only person that they got to, you know, replay this role again. And honestly, after rewatching it, I really think after watching him here, I really do think they could have just gotten someone else, because clearly this did not work at all. So yeah, the cast really does not deliver here very much at all, and I have to say, them being one of the things I think is one of the biggest draws, it's very disappointing for me to say that really only two performances here really worked for me. But now let's get to the directing and the writing, which this is really what I think brings down this entire film, is Jon Favreau's directing. Look, coming off the heels of Jungle Book and things like that, I think that's similar to the acting. That's something we were all just expecting to be really great. We were expecting it to have this great vision, and, you know, considering how much Favreau spearheaded his previous film, Jungle Book, and really brought something new and different and reinvigorated in sense of purpose, and I think he did an excellent job with that for sure. Here, it could not be more opposite. In fact, if you had told me that, if I had not known going into this that Jon Favreau had directed this movie, I honestly wouldn't have been able to tell, because there is no style here. Apart from the style that the film already had, there's no sense of style whatsoever. It doesn't really feel like there was much soul put into this, and it really does show. I feel like Favreau, he just kind of did this because Jungle Book was a success, and Disney wanted him to do a Lion King remake, but he didn't really have any sort of passion to do it, and you really do see that here, and it brings the entire film down, I have to say. And that's the thing, the best of these Disney remakes have been the ones where the directors have put their all into it. Bill Condon, Lion, or, you know, what say, even what Kenneth Branagh did with Cinderella. I mean, they all brought something different to those films, but that's just not the case here. This film just, it doesn't really feel like it has a director, and I think it really just brings the entire thing down. Now, in terms of the writing, I'll just say right now, there really is not a lot to talk about, because aside from a couple things, this is pretty much a shot-for-shot remake, and that really disappointed me. And look, I know some people are going to be fine with that. They want to go see The Lion King, and look, if that's what you're going for, go see it. You'll enjoy it, most likely. I, on the other hand, I want reasons for films to exist. I want films to justify its own existence, and this film really does not do that. I mean, there are a couple things that they do change, but all the changes that they've made, it seems like they did it to make this film feel more serious and make it feel more epic, and I really don't understand it all. One of the weirdest ones has to be what they've done to the character of Rafiki. This is someone who, in the original, he is so energetic. He is so just wacky and things like that. I mean, one of the best scenes in the original film is when he whacks Simba on the head, and, you know, Simba's like, "What was that?" for, and he tells them that it doesn't matter, it's in the past, but there's nothing like that here. This Rafiki is so serious and so toned down that he's just boring, and there's a lot of characters that are like that here. The hyenas, for example, they don't laugh anymore. They will make jokes occasionally, but they don't laugh anymore, so you don't really feel the comedic timing as much. It doesn't really make sense to these characters, and I don't really know why they had to make some of these changes that they did. It just feels pretty arbitrary. And look, a lot of things, the main thing that I've heard people say, like the biggest change they've made, is what they've done with Nala and things like that. And you know, a lot of people said, oh, Nala has a lot more to do. And really what they mean by that is that every so often they will cut back to Nala and Sarabi, show them struggling when Scar has taken over the kingdom and things like that. And it feels so unnecessary. It feels like the only reason that it's here is because, oh, we gotta give more to all the female characters. They don't have enough to do. And it never at any point feels like it needs to be here. The only reason it's here is just because they can, and because they need whatever excuse they need to pad the movie out. And it really does show here. It shows that you really did not have to change anything to The Lion King, because it's already perfect. All the changes they make here, they just come across as awkward and strange, and I don't really know what they were thinking. And look, there are things that they could have done, like Mufasa especially has even less to do in this film. I feel like, again, because James Earl Jones was not giving it his all like he was in the original, he does not stick out as much. They could have done something here where we dive a little bit more into who Mufasa is, or who is, or his past, or something like that. And there was a scene where I thought maybe they were going to do that. Maybe they were going to expand upon it a little bit, but they never do. And that really does kind of bring things down. And again, look, writing-wise, it's The Lion King. It's still well-written. There's still things that you'll like, for sure. All the stuff that was well-written in the original film, it is well-written here. It just doesn't have that same energy and that same freshness to it, because you've seen it before, and it just doesn't really work here. So again, there's just not much to talk about in terms of the writing. It's just really lazy. It really is. I feel like there's a lot more Disney could have done here, and they just didn't think about it. They wanted to deliver the safest movie possible, and it very much does show here. But easily, the worst thing about this movie has to be its animation. Now look, I will say, I think no matter how you feel about this movie, you cannot deny the level of expertise that went on here. I mean, the level of craftsmanship and things like that, it's undeniable, for sure. I think that the set look, the sets and things like that, when you realize those aren't sets, and you realize they weren't on those locations, and all of this was done through animation, it's scary. It is. It's scary how real it looks and things like that. And yes, it very much is game-changing in that way, because I don't think anyone ever thought we could get to that realness in terms of animation. And that's why so many people are calling this a live-action film, because it looks live-action, when in reality, it's completely photorealistic. And I think that definitely is really well done. However, the problem is really that because it is so real, when these animals are supposed to emote and things like that, it just doesn't really work. You don't really feel the emotion ever because lions don't emote all that much. And that's something that I think Disney did not take into consideration. I think they saw how much people were loving, you know, the realisticness of the Jungle Book and things like that. But with the Jungle Book, those animals, they still had like cartoon-like facial features. Whereas here, all of the animals, they just look like regular animals. And so because of that, it's very hard to connect to any of these characters. When, you know, the famous scene happens when Mufasa, not a spoiler, I mean, everyone knows Mufasa dies. When Simba's supposed to be reacting, he has very, very little reaction to it, and it just doesn't really work as well. Or a moment where Simba is supposed to feel happy, you don't really feel that. The only emotion you feel is the anger, because lions are good at conveying that. But anything else, it really doesn't work here, and that was very disappointing to me. I really feel like it's all they just got a little too heavy-handed with trying to make it look as realistic as possible. They didn't realize how just uncanny it really does look. It doesn't really work here. And I'm not gonna lie, there are many points in this movie where I felt like I was watching a Disney nature documentary. There are points where it's just animals and they're not talking, and I'm like, wait, when's the narrator gonna come up? I legitimately felt that way. I'm not joking, you guys. This is not me trying to be funny. Like, I legitimately was in the theater, like, where's the narration? Like, it feels like a documentary. It doesn't feel like a actual movie where you have characters. It just feels like one of those documentaries. And look, those are well shot for sure, but they're documentaries. They're meant to be shown with a narrator. Here, it doesn't really work. I mean, what works for one medium does not work for, you know, all mediums, and it very much does show here. And I think that's something that Disney really should have taken consideration, and they didn't, and it just brings the entire film down. And as a result, what we have here is extremely soulless. It is lacking so much in terms of emotion, and because that, I just got really bored with what was going on, and I never thought I would say that about The Lion King, but yeah, I was bored during a very big portion of this movie, and that really did bring it down for me. The only thing that somewhat saves it are Timon and Pumbaa. When they came onto the screen, I was into it. I was enjoying their banter, their back and forth, and things like that. And Eichner and Rogan did a really great job. They do what they can to elevate the animation. And unlike the other characters, you know, they also are fairly expressive. Like, the other animals don't really emote all that much, but when Timon and Pumbaa come on, they are much more expressive. And I think they did a good job with that. It's just everything else, it's fairly boring to look at. I mean, again, yes, the landscapes are beautiful and they're very well conveyed, but the actual animals, they just don't have any emotion to them, and that brings the entire film down. In terms of the score, I mean, again, it's The Lion King. The music is iconic, and the musical numbers themselves, they are definitely really well done. I think that the actors did a good job performing them, unless you're talking about Be Prepared, which, without getting into anything, it's not even the same song anymore. It's barely even a song. It's more of like a chant, sort of. Like, they tried to make it like sort of like a motivational speech, and it really did not work at all. I really don't know what they were thinking, but they could have just cut it out from the movie entirely because it's barely even the same song, and I don't even know why they even bothered with it. Beyoncé's new song, by the way, feels so out of place. I don't know why it's in this movie. It comes at such a random time, and you think maybe like it's gonna be like a Speechless or an Evermore where it's going to fit diegetically into the story. No, it plays as a montage, and it's very odd to me considering that Beyonce is a character in this movie. You could have easily just had her sing it, but they don't, and it's very odd. I don't really know what they were thinking there, but it does not fit here at all. And again, it just feels like something that's just there to pad the movie out. And again, the songs are great, even though I am going to reiterate that the locations and the numbers themselves and like the choreography, it's just not there. That creativity, that fun, there's so little they can do with it. I Just Can't Wait to Be King really relied on its animation, and that's something that Lion King did as a whole. It relied on its animation. It was so vibrant and colorful. And because it's so realistic looking, there's very little they can do with it. So a lot of these numbers are supposed to feel really big. It's just animals walking through a field or just animals talking to each other. And it's just not very visually appealing. And those do bring these musical numbers down. Again, they're well performed for the most part, definitely. And I would listen to them on their own. But in terms of the actual movie, they're not very fun to watch. And that was definitely disappointing for sure. So yeah, that really brought it down. In the editing, like I said, this movie is way too long. There are many scenes that just drag on and on and on, and it just after a while, I was like, why do they even try to make this movie longer? Just make it the exact same length. It's already a shot-for-shot remake. Why even change that much? I mean, really, the only significant change they made, like I said, besides Nala, is the climax of the movie. They do some different stuff in the climax of the movie with the final fight. The characters get a little bit more involved and things like that, and that's kind of really it. There's not really much more going on there. Overall, I'm sorry to report, but The Lion King is nothing more than just a soulless cash grab. This film feels like something that Disney made because they are striking their own ego. They are obsessed with the idea of remaking every film possible, and they just thought, you know what? Lion King's our most successful property. Let's just do it because flocks of people are gonna go see it, and that's kind of it. There really is no other reason for this film to exist. It does absolutely nothing to change the story, minus a few little things here and there. It is pretty much a shot-for-shot remake, but it's one that is devoid of any personality, any sort of soul. It has actors that are very talented but seem pretty bored, minus Eichner and Rogan, and it has animation that, while it is beautiful to look at, it just doesn't really fit in this movie, and as a result, it just makes for a film that is just really hard to sit through and one that was already perfect. And I really don't understand why Disney even considered the idea of remaking this. The whole thing just feels very unnecessary. And like I said, Eichner and Rogan do provide some really nice humor throughout the film. There's one joke in particular that they do with Timon that I thought was honestly kind of genius, and I love what they did there. It's the only thing that felt kind of fresh and really creative in that way. There's not a lot of like that in this film, but that there is one joke that very much did have me for sure. But anytime they went away, this film is relentlessly boring and very dull, and honestly, just really didn't do anything for me. I sat there with a very blank expression on my face. I wasn't necessarily annoyed. I was bored, definitely, but it was more just, I didn't see a point in this existing. I was very annoyed at the fact that this was a thing. Look, I get it. Disney is trying to bring these films to new audiences. They're trying to expose kids to, you know, their older films and things like that, and that's great. And I think they're doing, I think that's a really great thing they're doing, but they've gone to a point where they're just feeling stale. They don't feel like they're working anymore. I feel like for a while they had something good going. I really loved the first three they put out, Cinderella, Beauty and the Beast, and The Jungle Book. I love all three of those. But after that, I feel like now they're just becoming really soulless. They seem to be relying solely on just nostalgia, but they're forgetting what made those films so great. And I think this film is the biggest offender of that for sure. I think the biggest problem with the movie is that they just forgot what made The Lion King so great. It's not just great writing, it's not just great characters, it's the nuances, it's the vibrancy of it all, it's the stunning animation, but especially it is the emotions of the characters, and that's what made us connect to this film. And I think that's something that they just simply forgot. And as a result, what we have is a fairly soulless film that for me was very hard to get through. This was an extremely disappointing remake. I think there's a lot of things they could have done for sure, but they really did not seem to focus on that at all. And so, unfortunately, I am I'm gonna give The Lion King overall a C minus. So over, guys, in my review of The Lion King, let me know if you guys saw this remake overall, left your thoughts in it. Like I said, if you want to just see the same movie again, by all means, go for it. I think you'll enjoy it for the most part. But again, it doesn't really do a lot to justify its existence. And I'm just questioning why Disney really wanted to do this if they had nothing different planned. I really don't understand it. But either way, guys, in my review, hope you guys enjoy it. We'll see you guys in my next video, and we'll see you guys for that. Okay, bye.